Welcome to Yong Tuition. This is my third response to Veritasiaum's big misconception about electricity. Unlike other YouTubers, I have been focused on his claim that the energy can be transformed from the battery to the electric bulb through the electromagnetic field outside the wires. And this claim is actually, as I mentioned before, based on an assumption that there must be an internal electrical current inside the battery. Of course, if we can prove that there's no such thing of internal current going on inside the battery, then his claim will become nonsense. Let's do it. We know during the discharging process, electron will move from the negative electrode to the positive electrodes to form the electrical current. But the question is, what would happen inside the battery? Is there any internal current that move from the positive to the from negative to the positive, so that we can form a closed current, electrical current loop? Actually, this is exactly the assumption made by Veritasia in his claim. Let's look at that pictures. By the way, Veritasia certainly is not the first person to make this claim. And from this diagram, you can see that energy would appear come out from the battery as indicated by this blue arrow in this diagram, which is a pointing vector. And eventually, like they move like a fluid around the conductor wire, and eventually they enter the electrical bulb. So that is process. That is energy transform process. Is that true? Well, if you just look at this, his own picture, to make this happen, he must assume that this magnetic field exists, represented by this blue circle in his diagram. Can you see here? So this is battery. So in order to create this magnetic field, he must assume that there is the internal current move inside the battery. Perhaps I can use this 3D tilt, 3D diagram. Aha, this one. So in this diagram, the yellow arrow represents the pointing vector. Presumably, it is represent the direction of engine flow from the battery. So in this case, the battery is acting as emitter. They can generate the electromagnetic wave. And of course, it's not true. And so his idea is that there must be an internal electrical current. Okay. But this is not the case. Everyone who have studied the electrical battery, and actually there are hundreds of papers you can Google, you can find from internet. And I'm surprised that he didn't do much homework about how the battery work. And to be specific, that the battery can be divided into two electrodes. One is a positive electrode, another is a negative electrodes. So electrons are chemically accumulated or generated near the cathode, the negative electrodes. But there is a very strong wall between these two electrodes. In other words, electron cannot move from one side to another. And this separated, this wall is actually called the polymer separator, if you have read the paper in the literature, actually the battery, the DC battery, can be described as an electrical source, and together with can be described as electron source and electron sink. So that there is no way that electron can actually go directly from the sink to the source. They are obliged to go all the way outside if there is a connection, if there is a pathway. So if you have read the Romeo and Juliet, then you will know that. And so this is probably what you would see in the theater, that actually the Romeo and Juliet actually can talk. If necessary, they can actually meet physically. However, in the case of battery, and the story must be twisted. In other words, the Junior's father must have built this the wall to prevent to meet physically. See, they can see each other. They became very in love, but they cannot get in closer or get in the physical contact. So that is the key issues. All right. So that's the what will be the consequences? What will be the consequence of this? You can also, so it's, everyone understand, you know, there's a sign of toilet. And this simply means that you cannot jump, you cannot move in between. So that is how to explain that the separator inside the battery. Another issue is that perhaps people get this idea of internal current from the definition of internal resistance. We know that the battery, when you deal with a real battery, and we are obliged to introduce effective resistance called internal resistance to describe the performance and the function of the battery. So that gives people a wrong. Perhaps that is why people have the illusion that electron, there is some physical resistor exists inside the battery, so that you can see the currents to move inside the battery, which is not true. So this resistance is just effective resistance. Yeah. And so therefore, perhaps that is a reason many people accept his claim that internal current exists inside the battery. Actually, another way for the school kids, they know that there is a separation. Can you see that between the positive and negative, there is a gap, which indicate that electron cannot jump from the negative to the positive or from positive to negative. So that is although this is some surprising for somebody, for many people even, but actually that is a fact. That's why invented is a symbol for the battery. And this is a more realistic description of what's going on inside the battery. During the discharge process, that the electron move from the cathode to the anode, while the positive charge, the lithium ion, diffuse slowly from the cathode to anode. But this doesn't mean that they have internal current formed, which is comparable, even equal to the external current we used in the Ohm's law. And there is a scenario where you can talk about internal energy. That is when the internal short circuit damage your battery. So for example, in this diagram, you can see that yes, internal current exists when the internal short circuit occurs. So that is something, I don't know why he made such a silly mistake, because there are hundreds, if not thousands, of the research papers you can find over internet that will tell you this internal structure and how the ion move, okay? How this, more importantly, how that separator must be applied. Implication. That implies that because there's no internal electric current, so from this diagram, you can see the red one, the current is constant, but inside the battery, the current is zero. Some people feel probably, oh, how can we, this is just something you have to accept. Although the electrical potential still continues. And this is some of the summary I would like to convey with you this time. One, there's no current can be found inside battery unless internal short circuit happens. Two, the two electrodes of the battery are separated by a layer that only allows ions to diffuse. Three, the electrons are locally generated at the cathode and can only reach the anode externally. Four, electrical current in the circuit is not continuous. The water cycle. By the way, I have to mention that there's another reason why people could accept his idea that there's such thing as internal energy inside the battery. That is because people use this water cycle as analog to describe the DC electrical circuit. Inside, you can see the water pump would appear as equivalent to the power supply, so that they can keep this water continuously do cycling. But this is not the case in the DC circuit. As we just explained, the electrons simply come from the cathode to the anode. There's no shortcut. Therefore, the correct analog analogy to use water flow to describe the electrical current in the DC circuit is this diagram, that water is lifted in the tank, is lifted up so that the pressure difference will make, or the gravity rather, will make the water fall down, but never return, okay? If you put the water pump here, there, and you are not described electricity, you are not described the battery anymore, okay? The battery will be, by the way, the number of the, I'll talk about this in our summary here. Where are we now? So number seven, the internal resistance is merely an effective resistance for describing the performance and the age of battery, as mentioned before. Number eight, once the chemically accumulated electrons are used up, the battery simply stops its functioning, as simple as that. So that's my proof that there's no such thing as internal current. And many literature, you know, you can find many papers in literatures. Of course, so far I just proved that his claim is wrong. Next time, I'm going to tell you another very important issue, which is also part of his big misconception about electricity. namely, how does electrical energy transform into other type of energy? Can electrical energy move, can be transformed through the wire? See you next time. Goodbye.